Hi folks, are you looking for the most important aspects of the software qualification test? You want to know what the worst pitfalls for each organization are? Then you have come to the right place. Just keep on watching. In this video, you will learn what the three most important aspects are that you need to consider when conducting software qualification tests according to Automotive SPICE. My name is Bhaskar Vanamali. I'm a principal assessor and trainer for Automotive SPICE. I have conducted more than 140 formal assessments and trained more than 250 assessors. My knowledge is not only based on theory, but I also support improvement projects. Okay, let's get started. What is software qualification test? The expectation is that you already have software requirements in place, so the goal is to check against these requirements and determine if they are fully met and correctly implemented. The test environment depends on the product, so examples are software in the loop, processor in the loop, and hardware in the loop. Since this process is carried out shortly before delivery of the software, either directly to the customer or as a basis for the system, there are close relationships to processes such as project management, configuration management, product release, and of course, software requirements analysis. If the software qualification test does not work well, errors can go undetected and customer satisfaction is going to drop. So what are aspects you should manage in this process? Aspect number one, you need a clear test strategy. Like all testing and supporting processes, software qualification tests requires the development and definition of a test strategy. You may have separate test strategies for each test level, but it is better to develop and coordinate the test strategy according to all test levels. This ensures that all requirements are covered and redundancies are avoided. The test strategy should cover the following topics: the test object in question, the methods for developing test cases and test data, like, for instance, development of positive and negative test cases, equivalence class testing, boundary value testing. A regression test strategy, which in Automotive SPICE terminology means that you define how you want to retest after bug fix or change request. The test environment, test coverage in relation to the project plan and the release plan, and last but not least, entry and exit criteria, and test interruption criteria. Of course, this process has a very strong relationship to SWE.9 problem resolution management. So you can use either the test strategy or the problem resolution management strategy to document how to deal with failed tests. Part of the strategy is also to define coverage targets based on the type of delivery. So here is a strong link to the project plan and the release plan. When you document a test strategy, parts of it can be generic and documented in the internal process description and the guidelines. Again, Automotive SPICE does not define how or where you document the test strategy. It may be distributed over several documents. The test strategy should also cover your approach to test automation. Generally, it can be said that test automation is always better than manual testing. But there may be tests that are too expensive to automate. Aspect number two, select the right test cases. This expectation may sound trivial, but it may be anything but. The process expects a selection of test cases to be performed for the various tests, depending on the goal of the test and the coverage. The aim and expectation are that for the different deliveries, the software is properly tested on the basis of the aforementioned test strategy. The idea is that you can have deliveries with different expectations. An example for a strategy could be that you have a complete coverage for all implemented software requirements for the important deliveries. For minor deliveries, only the delta of implemented requirements since the last delivery is tested. For this approach, of course, the right test cases must be selected. Another possible situation for test case selection would be regression test, which covers change requests and or bug fixes. Here, test cases are selected that cover the change requests or bug and the effects that they can have. The latter means that dependencies on requirements that can be affected by the change request or bug fix are also tested. Aspect number 3, establish traceability and consistency. This process also requires that you ensure traceability between the software test cases and the software requirements. Traceability can be established through hyperlinks like in DAWs, through specific traceability tools like in Rectify, through traceability matrices, or through other manageable means which are supported by your tool landscape. The purpose of traceability is that it supports consistency checks, like for instance checking the completeness and correctness of the coverage of the software requirements, that it supports the impact assessment in case of change requests or bugs, and last but not least, it supports the reporting of stakeholder expectations and identifies which requirements have been tested, often referred to as coverage reports. The second part of this aspect is the consistency, in this case between software requirements and the software test cases. Checks for consistency are typically if the coverage is complete and correct. This can only be performed by a review. If you cannot prove that your software is fully and correctly covered, you may release an insufficiently tested software, so it is in your best interest to ensure consistency. So, ensure that this review is properly performed. Would you like to learn more about Software Qualification Test? We have created a more detailed white paper that you can download for free by clicking on the link below. If you are interested in Automotive SPICE, you might consider subscribing to this channel. We provide expert knowledge on a regular basis. And don't forget to share this video with your colleagues. Finally, thanks for watching, good luck, and goodbye.